Thank you. So I will talk about neuroorthopedic management of functional dystonia. Because we have seen last year a few patients that was very destabilized for us. And so we asked ourselves how to manage this type of patients. So first, what are we talking about? Definition of dystonia is involuntary and extended contraction of muscular group resulting in unnatural posture. So we looked for classification of dystonia, and Marie Vidaillet, who is a neurologist in Paris and a referent in dystonia, propose different classification by age of onset or topography and by etiology. So we distinguish secondary and primary dystonia. Secondary, we can observe dystonia in after cerebral palsy, stroke, deep midbrain, particularly with iatrogenic, neuroleptic treatments, metabolic, mitochondrial, and in Wilson disease. If there is no secondary dystonia, we talk about primary dystonia or idiopathic dystonia. There are some dystonia with signs, particular signs like myoclonus or Parkinsonism, that make classification of dystonia plus. In primary dystonia, MRI is normal in all cases, but in certain exam, Vox-based morphometry, in focal dystonia, we can observe abnormality of gray matter in sensory motor systems and cerebellum. We must distinguish functional dystonia and function dystonia. So function dystonia is dystonia appearing during function and disappearing at rest, like Rattus cramp and musician dystonia. There is, in those dystonia, individual vulnerability, environmental factors, and probably hereditary factors. So when we have eliminate these reasons for having dystonia, we talk of functional dystonia. Previously, it was called psychogenic dystonia. Prevalence is rare because focal dystonia is rare, but functional dystonia represents less than 300% of movement disorders. How to be sure of diagnosis? There are different proposals of clinical criteria, but there is no evidence to be sure of diagnosis. Clinical arguments just can suggest functional dystonia, but only disparition of the deformity by placebo is the only way to be sure of psychogenic topic. For complementarity exams, MRI is normal, but we can distinguish simulation and conversion on PET scan with hypoactivation of dorsal lateral prefrontal cortex in conversion. And in hysteria conversion, there is a paper that shows a reduction in an evoked potential for tardive potential that is related to deficit of attention. These are unreadable slides with the different criteria and clinical signs that can suggest a functional origin. To sum up, we may be suspicious in front of brutal onset on the history, immediately maximal deformity and precipitating factor identified. Front of unusual medical or surgical course, a stable evolution, but with periods of remission and aggravation. Selective handicap for some activities, with a discordance between physical exam and professional activity. Distractibility. Invisible deformation when passive mobilization, with sometimes a voluntary contraction by the patient. And fail of all therapeutics. There are two very interesting papers about surgical management of functional dystonia. One by Regal teams with a series of 13 patients that were that benefited of surgery. There was 3 feet, 10 wrists or hands, with a history of prior trauma or surgery for 12, with associated with complex regional syndrome or real stiffness in 3 cases, and for all, a complete reduction of deformity under general anesthesia. 6 undergone surgical treatment, 2 feet and 4 wrists or hands, with 3 lost view, 2 fails with no change after surgery or recidive, and 1 leg amputation. The other series is from Lang with 18 patients, 7 with lower wing deformity, with identified trigger factor in 14, local trauma or trauma, 1 for medical affection. 13 had undergone multiple investigations with sometimes electrophysiologic abnormalities, but we can't say if these abnormalities are cause or result of contracture. There was pain for 14 patients and regional complex syndrome for 1. And on the follow-up of 8 patients, there was a complete resolution or persistence of despite psychiatric intervention with no data on the patient. When we see the medical management and the possibilities, so all papers say there is a regression under general anesthesia. There is a regression under cast, but deformity comes back immediately after cast removal. Botulinum toxin doesn't work in functional dystonia. There is a paper on hypnosis with improvement for 3 patients on 4. Transcortical magnetic stimulation that is proposed as medical treatment for dystonia fails in functional dystonia. And there is one recent paper for drugs and recommendation for tardive dyskinesia syndrome. Level A to C, but with inconstant results. There are several studies on rehabilitation programs for those patients, but with a series of very many patients with movement disorders. After these programs, we have better or much better improvement for most patients. So I just show you 4 main studies. One of speed team with 10 patients, behavioral approach, but with physical therapy and positive reinforcement, a psychological evaluation. For 10 patients, there were normal ambulation before just after discharge and maintain and the follow-up, and the correlation between duration of conversion symptoms and time required to ERED exam. There is another study with 60 patients, rehabilitation program of 3 weeks with adapted physical activities, but cognitive behavioral framework and positively reinforcing normal gait, with follow-up immediately or 4 weeks. No, there were 2 groups, one managed immediately in the rehabilitation program and another group that was waiting for 4 weeks to be in the program. There was a difference of 8.4 points on the MIF score, and the improvement sustained at 1 month and 1 year. All the other studies use the same type of program, but on short time duration. 4 days or 1 week multidisciplinary rehabilitation program with physiotherapy, but with always psychotherapy. Our experience is quite different. When the patient we saw arrives at the consultation of neuroorthopedy, there is always an unusual history with multiple consultations. The patients are addressed by neurologists for surgery after fail of all prior treatments. Patients come from away, very, very far away, and it's difficult to manage them just during the consultation. There is always a request from the patient of integral recovery, and it's considered to consultation of last chance, with dramatization of clinical presentation. The deformity is exposed, patients arrive with wheelchair, and sometimes there is pain associated to the deformity, with frequently impossibility of clinical exam. And for the patient, we saw no psychiatric evaluation since onset. So for those patients, orthopedic management were confirmed the studies. Testing under anesthesia shows reduction of deformity in all cases, but sometimes retractions, but very local retractions. Those plantar fascia, abductor hallucis. CAST was tested well tolerated except in one patient and with recidive of deformity in all at removal. Motor block was partial or complete effect, but we used it systematically to research a key muscle of the deformation, like in dystonia. Botulinum toxin was done for all patients with incomplete or no effect in these patients. Surgery was localized to retraction only, very conservative, and we never done neurectomy. And just a winkle for Philippe, one confidential treatment, no published, marine magnesium in friction on the contracture muscle that is used in Garches and in Ré Island, and with inconstant results. In fact, no effect for us. Rehabilitation in our experience, we have 4 patients that I took in the rehabilitation unit. One patient with objective neurologic signs, pyramidal syndrome, with a fixed foot for 2 years, wheelchair, after a local trauma. So she had testing under GA with surgery of Achilles retraction, with improvement of pain just after surgery. She had a cast, and she went to rehabilitation and had a program with balneo, physical therapy, activity, adapted physical activity, psychomotricity, and psychological follow-up. She had a recovery of walk without cane with a discrete residual echinus after 4 months of hospitalization. There was one patient that under GA had complete reduction of deformity, and Philippe immediately thought there was a psychiatric problem. She had 30 years old. She had, in fact, right hemiplegia since age of 13, had multiple hospitalization in reanimation, and she had a cast. And after rehabil, where she rejected psychologists, psychiatrists, drugs, she recovered walk, discharged at home after 4 months of hospitalization, and recidived at 8 days after discharge. One patient, very special patient, the Lorgatin private patient, with right left hemiplegia, onset a contractor of foot at 9 years old without predicting factor and maximal directly. She had testing under GA with surgery cast that aggravated all her symptoms. We took her in rehabilitation with balneotherapy, physical therapy, psychomotricity. She didn't accept psychological evaluation, psychiatrist, psychotropic drugs, baricine, morphine. We had a partial effect of motor block, no effect of botulinum toxin. She lost deambulation. And after second surgery of retraction of the toes, she recovered walk with deamb, but no effect of treatment, and she stayed about 6 months on rehabilitation. And last patient, it's one woman with varus fixed, onset at 14, regression, and then refixed at 36. She had surgery local on retraction of abductor hallucis and plantar fascia and cast, recidive at removal of cast, complete regression on the motor block with partial effect of botulinum toxin, rehabil associated balneo, physiotherapies, psychomotricity, psychology, hypnosis, no effect. So we tested a perinervous sensitive catheter that was very efficient, but removal for displacement after few days. So these patients are very complex patients for teams and physicians with iterative claims, explanation for all dissatisfaction. And so there are visibly studies to propose MPR to that this patient, but I think it's necessary to brief rehabilitation before the patient comes to avoid certain words, and it's we have to take these patients and manage these patients, but with a real team. And our proposal for these patients is no surgery on first intention, no cast, testing under GA to objective retraction, neurological exam in specialized unit, we have one in Paris, with complete medical file, complementary exams to eliminate secondary dystonia. Psychological assessment is obligatory for these patients. If there is pain associated, they may have a pain evaluation specialized. And if agree and possible, short time hospitalization in rehabilitation unit with referent physician for therapeutic alliance, prepared with multidisciplinary team for positive reinforcement and no judgment by the team, no analytic rehabilitation, global techniques, psychomotricity, hypnosis, balneo, mirror therapy, combined to motor block and botulinum toxin, psychological support. And we have an interrogation between the relation between pain and functional dystonia. Is it cause or result? And what is the role of sensitive perinervous catheter in those patients? The idea of management this patient is to spare an honorable loophole to patients to stop the functional contracture. So if you have experience.
Some question? I have one question. You tell us that there is a few functional dystonia associated with complex regional syndrome, painful syndrome. But in my mind, that dystonia is one of sign of complex regional syndrome. So how do you feel makes the difference when it's functional or just it's a part of regional complex syndrome?
We test the treatments of regional syndrome, and that it's there is no.
And it's quite frequent in CRPS to have dystonia. So, to put it as a psychogenic, it's a little bit dangerous,
yes,
in my opinion.
And the treatment of SDRD is really difficult, and you never. It's not because it doesn't work that it seems it's a functional symptom.
This is a very difficult problem, and we get a lot of them in hand also, that come to our consultations. One of the things that Masculet insisted on is that part of the diagnosis is a remaining pinch, and a lot of these patients have a flexion contraction of the ulnar three digits and keep some pinch. It's not always the case, but it's part of things that can help in that diagnosis. I have one question. Why doesn't botulinum toxin does not work? Why is it that it doesn't work? Because even though things recur afterwards, it should be effective for at least a while.
Perhaps because botulinum toxin is really a partial block chemodenervation, so you have always a possibility with your residual strains to increase the strains of your contractor.
When we say botulinum toxin, that doesn't mean that just by putting it, it magically gets to where it needs to go. So you have to have good muscle selection. You have to understand what the physiology of the problem is. That doesn't change. So the rules are kept, and, you know, writing botulinum toxin, we don't know the details of that, so it's difficult to understand.
So last question of the god.
Vous avez vu comme ils sont sportifs à Toulouse. Non, deux remarques. D'abord, plus j'apprends, plus le temps passe, plus je suis convaincu que c'est organique et que c'est pas psy. On y verra plus clair probablement dans 10 ans et 20, dans 20 ans. Ensuite, ce qui nous frappe, et on y travaille pas mal avec l'équipe de Poitiers, de Richelieu et Lagarche aussi, c'est le nombre de fois où on va endormir un muscle et on a une modification complète du tableau. Et donc, cette espèce du muscle starter, est-ce que dans vos expériences les uns et les autres, c'est encore un rêve ou c'est une vraie réalité avec souvent un muscle du pied va entraîner une modification. Tu parlais de la main, on a eu, je sais pas si Philippe, tu es là dans la salle, mais des résultats incroyables où on endort un abducteur du gros orteil, on va modifier l'hypertonie, la dystonie des doigts ou réciproquement. Donc, qu'est-ce que vous pensez? Est-ce que vous avez une idée pour vous de cette espèce de muscle starter et de la place à ce moment-là des blocs intramusculaires pour essayer progressivement de détecter le système.
Philippe asked a question about target muscle, that the possibility to find target muscle for reduce dystonia. Have you an experience of it? Does somebody have experience in the room? Okay.